Hi guys, welcome to this week's episode of In Style Country. I'm Jonathan Kane.
And I'm Jackie Turner, and coming up on this week's episode, Donald hangs out at the Americana Awards and does the red carpet.
And of course, Miss Stella Parton, she picks up her Emmys dress and walks the red carpet. Stay tuned, we have so much in store this week, I'm so excited.
Me too!
Hey, it's Donald with In Style Country, and I am hanging out with John Wolfe.
When she's all baby this and baby that, I'm like a runaway train running out of track. There ain't no holding me back when she's all baby this and baby.
Hey, man.
How you doing, brother?
Good. How are you?
I'm good.
I really like your color selection today.
Well, I got the memo, so I'm wearing the black shirt.
I promise we didn't plan this, as far as the shirt anyway, but you can definitely tell that maybe Texas country? I mean, is the cowboy hat. Are we always wearing the cowboy hat?
You know, I always wear the cowboy hat on stage. I have been known to wear a baseball cap every once in a while, but today I'm rocking the hat for you, my friend.
I'm just saying, does it matter? Do you feel different with a cowboy hat on? Do you think it affects, like, your performance or anything?
Oh, absolutely. You definitely get more country when you put the hat on, that's for sure.
She sounds like an angel cooking in the kitchen. I love to listen.
What about anything else that you wear that you're like, it's a must before I go on stage?
I'm a big vintage belt buckle fan, so I go out and around vintage shops and search for old rodeo belt buckles.
Okay.
But this one in particular, a good buddy of mine gave this to me, an old rodeo cowboy.
Yeah.
So I've been rocking this one lately.
What about anything else that you wear that you're like, it's a must before I go on stage?
Well, see, I know cowboy boots have gotten really popular with the square toe.
Okay.
But I still rock the pointy toe cowboy boots, a la Dwight Yoakam.
Okay.
That's just my style.
Those pretty red lips I want to kiss so bad, saying baby this and baby.
I don't have a belt buckle, I'm not wearing a cowboy hat, but I don't want to try your belt buckle on, but can I try the hat on real quick?
All right, I'll let you do this one time, buddy.
All right.
No.
Okay. Hey, thanks for hanging out. This is John Wolfe with In Style Country.
Hey guys, Jonathan Kane here with In Style Country, and so much fun right now. We have Miss Maggie Rose, one of the highlighted artists tonight on the BMI rooftop here in Nashville, Tennessee. Gorgeous night. Maggie, what a gorgeous job you did tonight.
Thank you. I'm just happy I was able to wear this kimono. It was not too hot.
Oh, don't even...
Isn't it gorgeous?
Don't even talk to me about it. Literally, I was like, oh my God, somebody that wears sequins and like gorgeous appliques. And we have to talk about some of the mastermind behind the look tonight. One of Maggie's amazing friends, butt stylist, Miss Raina. Raina, now tell me, when you saw this kimono, what was your first thought besides like losing your mind?
Well, I lost my mind, obviously, but I was just like, we have to have this in every color, every size. I don't give a shit what it is. Like, it needs to be a pillow or like a blanket, a kimono. Like, I just,
it's really have a comforter design in it. Raina is always the one who's basically saying, okay, you need to try this on. I know you want to walk by it. And together we style these looks, and she forces me to be more adventurous. And I think it helps me on stage, and I get to like manifest my art through her willingness for me to be daring. So it's pretty fun.
You can change your mood or personality instantly by putting on a different garment. And a garment like this, obviously you're gonna have fun. You might be going out for a gorgeous dinner or performing on the rooftop of BMI in Nashville.
Absolutely. And I like to separate a little bit of my hanging out in my bathrobe Margaret to Maggie Rose. And this is a way that I do that. I think it's a persona that you have to just kind of take on, and you're here to entertain people and help them escape. So this is how I escape from what I would normally wear anyway.
It's all about confidence. So major kudos to you, Raina, for really just instilling confidence and teaching how important that is. That's what fashion's all about.
Fashion is totally, artists would be nothing without that extension of their brand, and yeah. Have fun with it. And people can tell when you're uncomfortable in what you're wearing. So that's part of the outfit, is the confidence that you wear behind it. It's the best accessory.
I'm Esri, you're watching In Style Country, and I am with this fantastic group, Southern Halo Girls. Can you introduce yourselves?
Definitely. I'm Natalia. I'm Hannah.
And I'm Christina.
And we're Southern Halo. Hey.
They are the trio from Mississippi. They, of course, are sisters. If you couldn't tell, look at their stunning beauty. You should hear their vocals, though. I was so happy to go ahead and get to be with you guys. I love your sound.
Oh, thank
now,
you.
Welcome. So, who do you guys get compared to?
Oh my goodness. You know, a lot of people like to compare us to the band Perry, because you know when they used to be country, the three siblings, they're from Mississippi as well. Yeah. And also Little Big Town.
Yeah.
So that's right. Also, and the Dixie Chicks.
And the Dixie Chicks.
We get called the Dixie Chicks and Shadaisy quite often.
Yeah.
Or like,
Shadaisy. Well, there's nothing like the sibling harmony to me. So have you guys been harmonizing your whole entire lives? Like, how did this start happening?
Well, you know what? We actually did start at a very young age, so I'd like to say it's been our whole entire lives, considering we've only been on the planet for a few years.
Yeah, but babies.
Yeah, we just grown up, just love singing together. We each actually found our own individual instruments that suit our personalities like very well, if you ask me.
Oh yeah.
And I mean, we just enjoy it together. It's just a big load of fun all the time.
So tell me a little bit about your personal style. What is it you guys like to gravitate towards right now?
Oh my goodness, that's so funny you ask, because a lot of people think we're so similar considering that we're sisters, but we actually each have our own individual styles and likings. So I actually like lean towards the more classy side. Like, I like dainty jewelry and, you know, very faded colors, very classy chic.
Right,
And then Hannah over here.
I'm very laid back. I like anything like comfortable, you know, just loose. And then Christina.
And then I've got this like grunger, rock chick edge kind of a look. I love lots of leather, lots of big pieces of jewelry.
I actually wore huge hoops and I swap guitars. Like, I play acoustic and then I play electric.
Right.
So just taking off the guitars on and off, I actually ripped an earring out of my ear on stage.
It was
quite dangerous, actually.
The show must go on, but you learn your lesson. That's what life is all about.
Yeah.
Okay, so what do you guys love on social media right now? What are some things that you're really into?
Oh my goodness. Mm-hmm. Well, on social media right now, like, I'd like to give tips on, you know, we are three girls, so we like to take selfies all the time.
All the time.
And you know, having to constantly post. So we actually found this really cool thing that we like to bring around, and it's called Social Light. You stick it like to the top of your phone, and it's like instant selfie lighting.
Yeah,
it's
I love
amazing.
That.
Yeah, you guys can try it out.
Well, it was great catching up with you guys. I'm Esri. You're watching In Style Country.
Is this on?
And I'm Donald S. Jenkins. In case you're not following me, and honestly, we're just gonna talk, and we're not even.
This is In Style Country with Brittany and
Brian Kelly. Don't touch that dial.
Guys, I'm from a kind of a small town in Bournemouth. I don't get, you know, grand houses and all these wonderful things to look at, but there's so many beautiful homes here, and I just want to kind of get inside some of them. It'd be lovely to see what's going on inside these beautiful houses.
Well, you know that a home is someone's, like, their happy place where literally they can unwind after a long, crazy day. So we have a little bit of a surprise, Jackie.
We
have Country Cribs.
Hey guys, it's Donald with In Style Country, and tonight I'm hanging out with Adley Stump. You may know her by NBC's The Voice, Team Blake, now back out on the road with Blake Shelton. And you don't want to miss tonight. We get the exclusive brand new apartment. It's only night two. Check this out. One love, two love, three love, four. He gets a little bored and he runs for the door. That's why you Actually, you can just tell me how great I am, because the audio is not going to be on.
None of this is going to be used. That's perfect. Your hair's messed up.
What? That is not In Style Country. My hair is never messed up. Hey guys, it's Donald with In Style Country, and I am hanging out with the Adley Stump. Really good friend. That's not a lie. I'm not just saying that. Like, I'm a good friend, right?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, you heard it from her.
Totally paid me to say that.
Hey, I have to make a living somehow.
I just moved into Peyton Steaks down here in Germantown 2 nights ago, hence why we're sitting on pallets. But I had to...
Wait, this is not the real furniture?
I don't think so. After tonight, I think I'm just not going to get a couch. We're just going to live on inflatables and...
I mean, I thought this was country style right here. Like, In Style Country, this was your couch.
I actually decorated all like this just for you guys.
Perfect. You go on The Voice. You're Team Blake now, right?
Yes. Yeah.
But we have to talk about your audition. Like, the first time you auditioned for The Voice, because I'm going to get this clip, if you send it to me, of, like, tell us.
Oh my God, it's so, I'm gonna talk about the first time I ever sang on a stage. Really? It was.
You drove all night drinking energy drinks.
Yeah, clearly cared about the quality of my voice. It was a dare for my sorority sisters back in college, and you don't turn down a dare in college. So, drove through the night after an intramural game, auditioned, somehow kept going. I was like, what are you doing? You've got the wrong girl. But it, long story short, it changed the course of my life in the last almost 5 years. I can't really believe it, but we've been really blessed that the stages and opportunities have just continued to grow.
Now, your hair was a little bit different.
Yeah, it was a lot different. It was just big. It was on top of my head. It attracted bees, is what it did. It was just like a giant hive on top of my head.
We need bees.
We do.
So that's a good thing.
Well, you're all welcome.
No, here, let me tell you what it says to me. All right. It says, here's who I am, like, accept me or not. And I think that's really what the audience, besides your, like, gorgeous voice, and your talent of writing music, when you get up on stage, I think anybody and everybody goes, I can relate.
I think so. With the hair, I wish, I used to think, and still part of me does, that somebody would have like stopped me. Somebody would have said, hey, Ad, that's like really bad looking. But whether people loved it or hated it, because it was very polarizing, you either loved it or you hated it. But no matter what, they knew who I was because of it.
They knew you were being real.
That was real. Wasn't that, it was maybe not the right or the best decision, but it was authentic. And that's been the foundation and the bedrock of everything, especially being in the entertainment industry, that if you don't have that foundation, no matter how tall your ladder goes, how fast you go and propel yourself through this industry, you have to have that bedrock, or you're just going to keep chasing carrots out in the distance that may or may never happen for you.
We're not gonna go in like, you know, how they say on Cribs, like where the magic happens, because right now you're on.
It's a blow up bed. It's really exciting, though. It's really exciting. But you guys will have to come back when we've got it all finished.
All right, I will. We're coming back. That's an invite. You heard her. Can we cheers tonight, too?
Yes.
Awesome. Hey, I am hanging out with Adley Stump. This is In Style Country, in for Nashville. And hey, cheers.
Cheers, baby.
Thanks so much.
So I just got to sit down with Rick Monroe. He has a gorgeous style. I think he's got great jewelry.
Oh my goodness. His jewelry is insane. He's such an artist in so many ways. And you can just see the style oozing out of him. That's why all the ladies swoon every time he's in a room.
Check this out.
Hey, everybody. Josh Conner for In Style Country. Sitting down, little chat time with Rick Monroe.
What's happening, man?
How's it going?
It's going good. How you doing?
So you've had several releases out. Talk a little bit about those and your latest.
One of the first ones was Against the Grain, where we had covered Midnight Rider, and that was like, that got us like on CMT and all this. And you know, we came to town thinking we were like set and rolling, and as Nashville is, you have to get in line.
Steamrolled.
Yeah, right? they're like, no, get back in line and sit. And then we worked on another one called It's a Love Thing that came out. We've done a couple different singles in between, and then the Love Thing CD had the first single was Fires Out, the second one was Great Minds Drink Alike, and they both charted pretty well, you know. And then now we've got the newest one, Gypsy Soul.
By the way, I have to mention this because the album cover for Gypsy Soul, incredible. I love the rings.
Yeah.
Talk about the rings for a second.
That's right here. This is a company called Speakeasy Original. These guys, one guy goes, man, because I had some other ring on. He's like, send me your logo. So I sent him the logo, and then this just showed up. Cool. And I was like, that's cool. And so when we were going to do the new EP, I had another ring that said Gypsy Soul, and he's like, no. Yeah, let me make you some.
Cool. So those are custom pieces.
These are all custom, yeah.
It's Rick Monroe. InStyleCountry.com is where you can find out more and see other interviews from country stars like Rick.
So our gorgeous Donald got to hang out in one of our local hotspots here in Nashville, Acme Feed and Seed. It's a great venue, and he got to hang out with the Swan Brothers.
Yes, now these guys are rocking, fresh off of tour, and let me tell you, not only do they have amazing music, they have flawless hair.
What's up, guys? It's Donald with In Style Country, and I am hanging out pretty excited. Well, actually, excited and intimidated, because I'm going to be honest, guys. I was at the studio. I went to the Swan Brothers, and I was like, hey, guys, I kind of want some fun facts. And there were some girls in the office. They were like, well, they have great hair. And I was immediately got intimidated. You start sliding over. We can't get no closer. Ain't no room in
honest with me, who spends more time in front of the mirror?
He's going to, obviously, we're going to say the other, but it's definitely him.
Honestly, this is all natural. I don't even put anything in it.
Oh, my God. Oh, I didn't even go there, but that was perfect.
You know what? It runs in the family. I've tried to maintain it, but my dad just happened to be, like, part Sasquatch, so.
And both have great beards. Great
new the beard we get from mom, so thank you, mom.
Do you style yourself or does someone else style you?
Both. I mean, we have once a year we have a stylist that will kind of pick out some pieces for the year that we'll kind of focus on, and which is really weird for me. I think it's really cool because I like having someone bring clothes to my house.
Right.
But that's just, it's weird. We've never done that. But I will say, like, for the most part, when we're out on tour and stuff, we pick what we're going to wear. And more times than not, we end up working or sometimes wearing the same thing, same color at least.
What? That's right, because when you grow up, right? I mean, while I think we're all, regardless of guys want to admit it, we're kind of wondering how we look, right? But it's not like when you grow up, you have somebody coming in other than your mom going, no, let's put this with that, right? Like, so, you know, now, but you're out on tour every night, you're in front of big crowds, right? You don't want to wear this. You don't want to wear the same thing every night, or do you? Maybe you do. Maybe you have that one thing that, like, you know what, when I'm on stage, is what I wear. Do y'all have that?
You know, I have a few of those. Like, I will wear a white t-shirt, like, over and over and over, and it's not the same t-shirt, I promise. You can tell by the
trust me, we know. Ask anybody in our band.
We both got matching tattoos for this upcoming tour, and just for life in general, man, and it's basically just about being brothers. It's a verse, Proverbs 17:17, and so we're really pumped about that, and that's like one thing that I think we could add into our fashion world a little bit. So
we did it on his birthday, which is August 17th, 2017. It was his first one, so it's pretty cool. I've been trying to talk him into it for years.
That's actually a really good story. It just has so many meanings, right? So at the end of the day, that had to be like absolutely a sign. You have to have that. But that's one thing that you share every night on stage, correct?
Absolutely, we share it, and that's forever now. That's in there.
Well, hey, thanks so much for hanging out. Is there anything that you know that you're really excited about that, like, we just want everybody to know this? And
Don't Call Me has been out for a little bit, and it just hit a million streams on Spotify, so that's great. We just announced our first headlining tour. We've never done this before, and so we're really excited. And we actually get to bring out a Caroline Glaser. And she's going to be opening up on some shows in some cities. And I'm getting married to that Caroline Glaser. She's playing right now. So
what?
So that's coming up too.
So what you're saying is you have a pretty good opener.
That's right.
Hey, guys, I'm hanging out with the Swan Brothers. Not only are they unbelievably talented and great people, they got great style and, really great taste in women as well. I mean, can I say that? You're watching In Style Country.
Hey guys, this is Brooke Hogan, and you're watching In Style Country. There you go, making me feel beautiful. I want to know, am I the one you're looking for? Dropping hints, falling in, wondering. Don't want to be just friends, boy. I want to be your girlfriend. This week's fashion tip?
That's right, it's coming to you from our rhinestone heiress.
Hi, this is Morelia, the rhinestone heiress for N Style Country. And as you know, fashion's always a fun, great thing when scarves are a great extra plus. As you can see, I have a cool Manuel scarf on, and I'm going to tie up Donald, in fact. And it's really simple. You can do a loose, let hang loose, or do a double knot like most good Girl Scouts know how to do.
So what do you think?
Looking rocking.
I'm going out like this tonight.
All right.
That's In Style Country.
Nashville hosts the Americana Music Festival. It's incredible.
I mean, a whole week of amazing music and artists and an award show. And of course, In Style Country was there. So we're bringing it to you right now.
Hi, it's Donald with In Style Country. I'm on the red carpet of the 16th annual Americana Honors and Awards Show. This is where legends and up-and-coming rising stars meet. We honor the legends, but gosh, these new guys, they're so good. And well, when it comes to style and fashion, well, you combine the legends with what the new... This is going to be exciting. Can't wait. Here we go. Hey, it's Donald with In Style Country at the 16th annual honors and awards for Americana, and wow, I'm hanging out with the Lumineers right now.
I don't think we've ever actually won an award, so this will be interesting to see if we break the trend, but it's a high honor to just be, I guess, nominated, and we're going to play a song tonight, so in the Ryman, so it's, the whole thing is a huge honor to be around the artists that are coming out tonight. It's sometimes overwhelming,
you know? You know, I agree. I've been here 15 years, and I can say that if you're here and you're nominated, you've already won. Because I know this is not an overnight thing, right? And I really want to know, guys, be honest with me, who takes the longest getting ready? Who wants to answer this question?
I wear the same thing every show, so I might be the fastest. I wear white shirt, suspenders, the belt, which I've heard is a fashion faux pas. Maybe you could corroborate that. Is that?
No, honestly, I'm just in a research mode. I don't give any fashion advice. I ask.
Okay. So observatory scientific mode? I'll take that.
Well, let me ask you.
2 seconds to get ready.
That's awesome. Does it have anything to do with comfort, superstition, or is this just what I do and I always have done it before I was even doing it on stage?
I wasn't liking what my civilian sense of style is doing. I look like an idiot when I'm off stage all the time. I wear sweatpants. It's a disaster. So I wanted something really simple and not have to think about what I wanted to wear.
That's awesome. Now, as far as these guys, now, who spends more time on their hair? And I guess, I mean, they have more hair on their face and everywhere. So there's really a lot to go with that. But what about you? I mean, you get to be all the time on stage. You're gorgeous. Love how you look. Is there any, do you have a stylist or something that says, hey, let's stay in between, or is this all, hey, I wear what I like?
Yeah, I think before a show, it's important for me to kind of have some alone time. And so I'm sure someone could put me together quite well, but I like to do it myself. And I actually just cut like 8 inches off my hair, which is, I should have done it ages ago. It's so much easier. I got ready really fast for this tonight.
I don't know what message we're trying to send other than we're constantly changing how we look, but not many people know what we look like anyway, so it's fine.
Oh, that's not true.
Yeah. No, it is. We're pretty anonymous.
So it's not true. A lot of people know you, I promise.
But no, I mean, I only recently got into, like, even being able to buy a suit jacket, so when we were in London, we met Paul Smith, so I'll give him a shout out. I don't know where
he's from. Nice. But, okay.
Yeah, he's a sir, Paul Smith, and he's got these little touches, like some little green. I really like his stuff. So.
Very cool, Paul Smith. Well, guys, thanks so much for hanging out. Congratulations on your nominees. Best of luck to you, but I promise you, you guys have already won in so many ways, and excited to watch you as you grow. So awesome. Thank y'all for hanging out.
Yeah, nice to
awesome.
Meet you.
InStyle Country and the Lumineers, guys. This is Donald with InStyle Country, and I am hanging out, well, with people that have a lot better fashion than I do. I mean, because let's be honest, you guys do so much. You're so talented. You're so good at what you do. But I'm wondering, I really want to talk about your fashion.
We always try to make a statement in fashion as well as the music.
Yeah, for sure.
So our music is coming from our hearts. And when we greet other people, we like to see the smile on their face and say, oh, man,
what did you got?
You know.
So it's true that if you look good, you feel good?
Exactly, exactly.
Your stylist was your father, is that right?
Yeah, exactly. You know, Elvis used to buy his clothes from Lansky's in the early days. And we kind of just followed in his footsteps. He was a great guy. He picked out really great.
I've heard of Elvis before.
Yeah. That's unbelievable. No, that's right. But anyway, we used to play for some of his private parties when I was in high school. Yeah, we was like in the high school playing for Elvis Presley, you know. So we started buying our suits from the place that he brought his clothes.
Well, I thank y'all so much for really not only what y'all do, but the talent you have. And, gosh, you look really good. So I took some tips. I was taking mental notes the whole time. I was looking, I was like, I wonder if I could pull that off. Awesome. Thanks so much for hanging out with us, guys.
We really appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You guys know the runway where country music and fashion meet. You can always trust us to bring you everything styling in Nashville.
Who needs expensive furniture when you can prime now?
I don't play no furniture.
For
I'm gonna edit that part out.